I come from Pulwama, which is a district in South Kashmir. It's considered to be the most fragile districts right now, given the situation and given the turmoil we've been facing from last many years. So I work mainly with youth in Kashmir, and we are a state where right now the 69% of the population is young, and being in a conflict zone, we see a lot of uncertainty, challenges. So young people have been the primary casualty of this conflict. We all know how things have been gone bad in Kashmir in the past. We've seen cycles of violence in 2008, 9, 10, and even 16, where a lot of young people lost their lives. So what we did as an intervention, our interventions, especially what I did, I joined PDP as a political party. I joined in 2013. We worked with youth and started reaching out to the young people and talking to them what's wrong and why were the young people getting indulged mostly into violence. So our process was based on three specific initiatives. And here I have mentioned some of the challenges that we are a state where 69% of population mostly young, and these are a few of the scenarios we were facing when we start interacting with the young people, that there was a lot of influence of violence on the young minds, and there was sense of defeat among the young people in Kashmir, because you were born in a conflict and a continuous conflict. You feel that nothing is happening on, there's sense of alienation is increased, there's anger more than peace. People aspire, especially the young people aspire for happiness. So what we did, we started understanding those problems, and one of the dangerous challenge that continues to be in rest of the world, even when we talk of ISIS, when we talk of intolerance in rest of the world, whether it is terrorism, communalism, or whether it is racism in some of the countries. Even yesterday I was reading paper, the concept of this blue whale game. So why do young people see a lot of dignity in death? Why do young people volunteer for death? That remains one of the major challenges when we work in a conflict society, that you have a lot of people who do not even aspire to be, you know, to live. And some of the young people, we saw that given the sense of defeat they felt, they started basically seeing and visualizing dignity in death, joining militancy, joining armed forces, and some of the pictures which you might have been seeing, that they saw role models out of dead people. So if you see people who are like dead, who join militancy, and you see them as a definition of dignity, so it sets a very dangerous trend. And that has been happening in a lot of parts, when a lot of people you see, those who are joining ultra groups, come from very, positive backgrounds even, but they've been continuously getting into radicalized or getting into such acts of violence. So I'm showing you a picture. This picture speaks about a situation in Kashmir. Can you make something out of this picture? So there is a very thin line where we work in. We work in these cross lines. It's a very thin line where we start talking to young people and interacting with them, indulging them, involving them in mainstream, getting into the process of democracy, so strengthening the process of democracy. And some of there is aggression, there is anger, there is destruction, there is feeling of being angry, uncertainty, insecurity. And some of these young people who have volunteered towards armed insurgency and who see a lot of dignity in violence or even death. And what our challenge, where our intervention came in, was that we started as a youth PDP initiative, which I headed the youth wing of the party. We started reaching out to the young people, and we almost designed a campaign called it Youth for Change. That campaign was about reaching out to small, to hold focus group discussions at village levels. We started going to young people and start, rather than lecturing them, we started listening to them so that they understand that there is dignity, they are being heard. The feeling of dignity should come by participation, by creating a participatory process. We started taking young, elder and senior leaders of the party, of the government, and involved them into the decision making with the young people. And it worked to a large extent. 3 years continuous reach out with a lot of young people. We had a 20,000 strong base in Valley, where young people who are connected, who are actively working with the youth wing. But what we realized after last year's cycle of violence was that the challenge was not the people who are above 18. Because in democratic process, you involve people in parliament, assembly, and panchayat. These are all age groups which are above 18. We started getting, we did a lot of initiatives with these young people. And one of the important initiatives we did with the government was that I was involved in the Chief Minister's Grievance Cell. We start reaching out, addressing the problems of young people, where we said, okay, there were 30,000 complaints registered, and we involved young people in resolving these grievances. So our target was like every complaint should become a compliment for the government, and every grievance should reflect governance in the system. So we start calling these people. We use social media, WhatsApp, and Twitter to identify grievances, reach it out to them, and resolve some of the grievances, and started calling these guys back that, so that the feeling of being heard was given. The feeling of dignity was also being, you know, responded by the state government. But what we realized is that the age of engagement was not above 18. So you have kids like 20 lakh kids who got indulged into violence, or who are vulnerable to violence. So what we started as another specific initiative was that how do we basically reach out to the age which is below 18, which are teenagers, which are juvenile, which are in schools, which are not part of a democratic process. So we did a very small pilot project in some of the schools where we got a student parliament concept introduced. We usually have a class monitor who's selected by madam. So he's selected by a class teacher, and he derives his strength from the teacher. So he does not have leadership qualities. We created a pilot project where we started this project where kids should be allowed to make and elect their leaders. And what the change that came in the class was that the people who came in front were totally invisible. The second change that came, that the people who came in front were really who had some leadership qualities. They were not intelligent, because intelligent students are like in minority usually in a classroom. They are intelligent, but they cannot, it's not necessary they have all the leadership qualities. So sometimes even copying qualifies to having leadership qualities, sharing your food, sharing your things with your friends qualifies to have leadership qualities in a class. So we did some of the projects to cater to that age. Was that this one of the projects we started engaging the young kids, so that you have a nursery of young people, kids who believe in the process of democratization, who get nurtured in the culture of democratization before they get indulgent into violence. So these are preventive measures we did as a second initiative, and this is now being institutionalized by the state government also. And one more important thing, I also had the J&K government sports authority, which is the state sports council. I had the council, and from last 1 year, what we have been doing, that we have 3,000 villages who got indulged into, you know, into street protests, and we got young people involved. So we started an initiative, Sports for All, where around 3,000 clubs were formed, and in the name of villages. So every village has its own sports club, and every club has a captain, has a coach, has a manager, and has 15 players included in that club. So these clubs became a huge chain of sports. One, we got data of every village, that what sports, which sports, and what is the number of people, what is the age, what is the gender, what is every sort of data we got from 3,000 villages in just 1 month campaign it was. And we covered 3,000 village clubs, 50,000 youngsters, 10 districts, 45 blocks, and 30 tehsils. Now this has become a huge campaign of the J&K government today, where sports is seen as an alternate discourse. Because when we talk about young people getting into violence, we created a concept that by using sports, you create positive alternate heroes, where young people basically aspire to see themselves role models through positive means by involving themselves in sports. And we use it social media, WhatsApp, Twitter, because these were a few of the mediums which were against, we use it for spreading wrong messages. So we use it social media, Twitter, WhatsApp, all these things to spread the message and visibility. The total activities which we conducted were, we involved at least in 22 districts, 89,000 players across the state. One of the important things that we did was inclusive sports, involving girls in sports, where you see a lot of pressure among some of the conservative societies when girls don't come out openly, they don't see themselves, they see the sense of being unfreeness. So we created an inclusive sports concept in Jammu and Kashmir. And the idea was where a girl feels that she's in charge of herself, she's in control, she doesn't need support, and she sees herself that my parts of my body is not sort of a liability, and I can, you know, I can become a star, I can be celebrated. And these are a few things which we did. And Rural sports was one of the important elements by engaging youth to mainstream, to discipline them, to involve them in positive, involve their positive energies, create local icons, local role models, where people say that the dignity in death should not be celebrated, where you have dignity in life. So these were a few initiatives. And the, one of the important thing we did was we got 207 people identified across the state, across regions, Jammu, Kashmir, Ladakh, across religions. And these 207 people were trained at the National Institute of Sports. Now they are back, and in each of them has been engaged by the J&K government and are have become community coaches. They are training 50 guys in their own respective villages. And it's such a huge campaign that the change agents on the ground, they're building professional sports spirit, disciplining these youngsters, building sports in Jammu and Kashmir in 14 separate disciplines. And the increase that we got in sports was tremendous. The total activities have gone, like if you see this map from 2014, the participation was 11,000 to 14,000. It has reached to 1 lakh in 1 year, which is huge in a place like Jammu and Kashmir, because it's not about just sports. It's about a meaningful engagement, and every act of governance engagement, positive youth engagement is under, I mean, pressure is under, you know, suspicious in a place like Kashmir, because you have a volatile situation going on from last year. So this was the activity grab that we saw. We got national parties, we increased the participation in national. This was our physical presence of this same council. It's almost in every district in 1 year we completed. And this was like a huge, with the youth campaign we created with the Sports for All. The total number of grounds we had was 103. And the total number of grounds today we are in possession of is gone 1,196, and this is huge campaign which is also done by the locals. So we are not investing money, we are not creating assets. So people come and participate in this process. They give us the land, they give us the registrations of their village, they find out spaces in their villages and come and approach to the government that these are places kindly occupy, kindly, you know, take them with the sports council, identify as them as the free space or playgrounds. So these are things which we have been doing and trying to involve people, young people across the board, involve more people in positive ways. And that's all. Thank you very much.